Hello students, let us study Bhakti Sufi traditions. Changes in religious beliefs and devotional texts from 8th to 18th century. In the first three parts of the video, we have seen the development of Bhakti and Sufi traditions in South India and North India. In this module, we will study new devotional paths, dialogue and descent in North India, sources to reconstruct the life of Kabir, teachings of Kabir, Baba Guru Nanak and his teachings, Mirabai, the devotee princess, reconstructing histories of religious traditions. New devotional paths, dialogue and descent in North India. During the 14th and 15th centuries, Kabir was one of the most outstanding examples of a poet saint. Verses ascribed to Kabir have been compiled in three distinct traditions. Sources to reconstruct the life of Kabir. The Kabir Bijak is preserved by the Kabir Panth, the Pad or sect of Kabir at Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh. The Kabir Grandavali is associated with the Dadu Panth in Rajasthan, and many of his compositions are found in the Adi Granth Sahib. All these compilations were made after the death of Kabir. Kabir's poems have survived in several languages and dialects, and sometimes with the special language of Nirguna poets or the Sant Bhasha and others known as Ulat Bansi, upside down sayings. Teachings of Kabir. Kabir tried to describe ultimate reality including Islam. According to him, the ultimate reality was Allah, Khuda, Hazrat and Fir. He also used certain Vedic terms such as Brahman and Atman. He also used some yogic traditional terms such as Shabad or Shunya. Some poems of Kabir expressed conflicting and diverse ideas. Some poems attacked Hindu polytheism and idol worship, and others used Sufi concept of Sikar and Ishq to express the Hindu practice of Naam Simran, remembrance of God's name. Historians have tried to analyze the language, style and content of these poems. Debates about whether Kabir was a Hindu or a Muslim by birth are well reflected in hagiographies. Hagiographies within Vaishnava tradition suggest that he was born a Hindu but brought up by a poor Muslim community of weavers. They also suggest that he was initiated into bhakti by a guru, Ramananda. The poems of Kabir used words guru and sadguru but do not mention the name of any specific guru. Historians pointed out that it is very difficult to establish that Ramananda and Kabir were contemporaries. Baba Guru Nanak and the Sacred Word. Baba Guru Nanak was born in a village called Nankana Sahib near Ravi in Punjab in 1469. He trained to be an accountant and studied Persian. He was married at a young age, but he spent most of his time among Sufis and Bhaktas. He also traveled widely. Teachings of Guru Nanak. His teachings are well reflected in his hymns. These hymns suggest that he advocated a form of Nirguna Bhakti. He rejected sacrifices, ritual baths, image worship, and the scriptures of Hindus and Muslims. According to him, the Absolute or Rab had no gender or form. He proposed a simple way to connect to the divine by remembering the divine name. He expressed his ideas through hymns called Shabad in Punjabi, the language of the region, and sang with different ragas. He organized his followers into a community. He set up rules for congregational worship or Sangat. He appointed one of his disciples, Angad, to succeed him as the preceptor or Guru. Guru Nanak did not want to establish a new religion. After his death, his followers consolidated their own practices to form a distinct community. The fifth Guru, Guru Arjun, compiled Guru Nanak's hymns along with those of his four successors and other religious poets like Baba Farid, Ravidas and Kabir in the Adi Granth Sahib. These hymns called Qurbani are composed in various languages. The 10th Guru, Guru Gobind Singh, included the compositions of the 9th Guru, Guru Tegh Bahadur. This scripture was called the Guru Granth Sahib. Guru Gobind Singh also laid the foundation of the Khalsa Panth, Army of the Pure. He also defined its 5 symbols: uncut hair, a dagger, a pair of shorts, a comb, and a steel bangle. It was under the leadership of Guru Gobind Singh that the community became a socio-religious and military force. Next, let us study about Mirabai, the devotee princess. Mirabai was one of the best known woman poets within the Bhakti tradition. She was a Rajput princess from Mertha in Marwad. She was married to a prince of the Sisodia clan of Mewar against her wishes. She defied her husband and not submit to the traditional role of wife and mother. She recognized Krishna, the avatar of Vishnu, as her lover. Her in-laws tried to poison her, but she escaped and lived as wandering singer, composing songs with intense expressions of emotions. Her most famous preceptor was Raidas, a leather worker. It shows her defiance of the norms of caste society. She had donned the white robes of a widow or the saffron robe of the renouncer. Although she did not attract a sect or group of followers, she has been recognized as a source of inspiration for centuries. We get information about her from the bhajans attributed to her. Reconstructing histories of religious traditions. Historians used a variety of sources to reconstruct histories of religious traditions. These include stupas, monasteries, and temples. Historians also draw on textual sources, including devotional literature and hagiographies. These sources enable historians to understand certain religious beliefs and practices. They range from the simple direct language of the Vachanas of Vasavana to the ornate language of the Farman of the Mughal emperors. Understanding each type of text requires different skills. Historians have to acquire familiarity with several languages and to be aware of the subtle variations in style that characterize each type. Historians have to understand that religious traditions, like other traditions, are dynamic and change over time.